Hundreds of protesters have returned to Melbourne CBD a day after violent clashes with police. The Occupy Wall Street campaigners claim officers used brutal force and they're now demanding compensation.
Flanked by hundreds of police, protesters again occupied Melbourne streets, but peacefully.
Democracy is under attack!
Up to 1,000 people marched down Swanston Street just 24 hours after it was a scene of bloody clashes. Police have come under fire for what some describe as heavy-handed tactics, which saw 95 arrests and dozens of people injured.
And some police officer reached over and punched me right in the eye, as you can see there.
I saw people getting ripped out and pulled into the police line and beaten. I saw people capsicum sprayed.
What we saw was absolutely unnecessary, brutal force.
Legal representatives for the group are calling for an independent inquiry and compensation.
I think we saw something that we'd all hope to say we'd never see again on the streets of Melbourne.
But Occupy Melbourne says its fight is far from over, vowing to move in to Treasury Gardens next weekend.
Protesters are also planning marches throughout the city next week, which could throw the Queen's Melbourne visit into disarray.
We have the right to free speech and the right to demonstrate in this state.
The sentiment is echoed in Sydney, where hundreds have set up camp in Martin Place, adamant their message won't be marred by riots.
It Occupy Sydney is determined to avoid violence.
Hermione Kitson, 10 News.